Hello there, how's it going? Well, I hope it's going well, and if not, you know, ask me a question, see if I can help in some way. Pop it in the comments and I'll get back to you. It's time for another chord, isn't it? Well, I'm going to go for G. This time, chord called G, G major. We don't usually bother with saying major because we just assume you mean major unless you say something else. So just the chord of G. And that's how I mostly play it, but sometimes I play it like that. And it's got a slightly different thing because I might be going to another chord. We'll talk about those other chords later, but the reason why I mention that is because there are lots of different ways of fingering chords. And there's a sort of an idea that, oh, there's a correct way and there's an incorrect way. And with some of these chords that are going to come up soon, I can't actually play them the correct way. So I've had to find a way of making it work for me because I've got rather, you know, big fat fingers and they can't squeeze into the places that they're supposed to. But I bring that up particularly because I want you to find out what works for you. If you can play the chords the correct way, and by all means you check out on the internet and see what other people say about how a chord should be played. This is a common way of playing the chord of G. Another common way is playing it like that. This is a related chord that is easy to play like that. But there are other ways of playing these chords as well, so don't worry too much about that. But find what works for you. I have certainly found from, goodness me, 40 odd years of playing, that, that the way that I play these chords does work. Okay, that's, so I would, you know, experiment by all means, but bear in mind that I'm not teaching you something that doesn't have some track record, if that makes sense. So, G. And the other thing I want to talk about is strumming, okay. So, I'm not expecting you to get to play like that just yet. But the point is, you might have noticed, and in fact, I'd be interested to watch back the video, I bet my hand was just bouncing in time all the way through. Now that sort of sounds obvious, but even when you're doing a funky rhythm, I mean, there's something like, now that isn't the way you'd play it. In fact, I've got a video, if I haven't already mentioned it, that I did a few years ago where, yeah, I go into you know, how to do the strumming, and it's basically, that's the trick. You get your hand bouncing in time, and then you decide whether you're going to play, you know, whether you're going to actually hit the strings or not. And I'll link to that video there, and you can watch that. So it's about time we did a song, and this time we're going really old-fashioned. Okay, it's an old folk song. In fact, it's I think it might be a sea shanty. It's certainly a sea song. It's a sailor's song, I think from the Navy back in the day. And it's, what should we do with a drunken sailor? And obviously it's going to use the chord G, but it's going to use some chords that we know already, the A minor and E minor, the first one we learned. So it goes like this. What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning. In fact, when I learnt it as a kid, it was early in the morning. And then it's hooray or way hey and up she rises. Way hey and up she rises. So, and it's a, you know, it's a fun old song actually, and you can mess with it, you can make up verses, there are lots of verses, some are a bit mean. If you know what keel hauling is, ooh, it's a horrible punishment that was done in the old days. And yeah, I wouldn't choose to be singing that particular verse, but you know, put him in the scuppers until he's sober. That's not too bad. It's just where the water flows over the side of the ship, I believe. Anyway, I hope you enjoy that, and I'll see you next time.